tonight from New Mexico, the land of enchantment. A very special Western. 52 beautiful young women from all over the country are after my title, and one of them is gonna get it.
Tingley Coliseum in Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Everybody have fun tonight.
Saluting the great American West, the 36th annual Miss USA pageant with Bob Quacker, Mary Fryer, Chuck Connor. 52 young women competing for more than $200,000 in prizes and one of the nation's most prestigious titles, Miss USA 1987.
And me, I'm Christy Fisher, Miss USA 1986, and I'm saying here we go!
In the parade of states, beginning with Miss Alabama.
Rhonda Garrett, Birmingham, Alabama.
Shelley Dunleavy, Anchorage, Alaska.
Diane Martin, Phoenix, Arizona.
Sherry Smeltzer, Smackover, Arkansas.
Lori Dickerson, Lodi, California.
Holly Kiscott, North Glen, Colorado.
Jolene Foy, Clinton, Connecticut.
Shelley Harrelson, Newark, Delaware.
Edwina Ridgeock, Washington, D.C.
Elizabeth Ampuleo, Grosse Pointe, Michigan.
Christine Rosenberger, South St. Paul, Minnesota.
Kathy Manning, Drew, Mississippi.
Dawn Fonseca, Independence, Missouri.
Connie Collins, Great Falls, Montana.
Amy Wynn Anderson, Kearney, Nebraska.
Tammy Lee Perkins, Las Vegas, Nevada.
Lori Gerke, Hampton Beach, New Hampshire.
Stacey Joy Fox, East Brunswick, New Jersey.
Kristen Kilgore.
now, let's meet our stars. Our batch of royalty, Christy Fitchner, Miss USA, and Miss Universe, Barbara Palacios Tede. Our hostess and co-star of the hit series Newhart, Mary Pratt. The star of The Price is Right and one of America's favorite television personality, our host, Bob Barker. And saluting America's armed forces, the Kirkland Air Force Base Sabre Drill Team, along with the Naval Air Training Command, Choir. Gentlemen, our host for this evening, Bob Barker.
Thank you, thank you, and good evening from beautiful Albuquerque in the land of enchantment. Tonight we add 53 more reasons for that title. Our 52 contestants and our enchanting hostess, Mary Fran.
Yes. And oh, what excitement there is here tonight, because it's Miss USA night live, and Bob and I are ready to bring it all to you. Bob will be on stage interviewing, introducing, and keeping things moving.
Mary will be talking with both contestants and guests and sharing special moments and information with you folks at home. But now, we are going to bring you a special swimsuit fashion segment, showing off our contestants against some beautiful New Mexico backgrounds.
Now, earlier you met our 52 young ladies in their state costumes, and you've probably already made some early choices as to tonight's winner. Well, now you can check those choices again as our candidates model their exclusive Miss USA swimwear by the JCPenney Company.
And I hope you have a pencil and paper handy so you can jot down your choices for our semifinalists, because I'll be back with those 10 names after the Miss USA swimsuit fashion show, which will also feature the art of New Mexico's national treasure, Georgia O'Keeffe, whose works are currently on exhibit in the Museum of Fine Arts in Santa Fe.
In reservation, in the shadow of the enchanted mesa, we meet our first two contestants, who shed their Indian blankets to reveal that they are Dawn Fonseca, Miss Missouri, and Catherine Manning, Miss Mississippi. Turning into our camera is Miss Pennsylvania, Lisa Renkevich. We interrupt the exercising of Miss Illinois, Joan Byrd. In the elbow of a massive rock stands Miss Oregon, Tamara Premiano. Next, two Southern Belles, Rhonda Garrett, Miss Alabama, and Miss Florida, Chloe Cabrera. Mountains and pottery set off the charms of Miss Hawaii, Deborah Laszlo. We greet Shelley Harrelson, Miss Delaware, and Donna Wilson, Miss North Carolina, before moving to another Georgia O'Keeffe painting. From her blue number two, we go to the Sierra Blanca and into Three Rivers Petroglyph Site and designs carved thousands of years ago with stone tools. Where a hand of friendship is offered by Miss California, Lori Dickerson. Snow-capped mountains form a backdrop for Constance McCullough, Miss New York. While stone-carved rocks surround Elizabeth Puleo, Miss Michigan. Here from another corner of the country comes Ginger Dawn Kilgore, Miss Maine. Hand in hand, a petroglyph and Miss Arkansas, Sherry Smeltzer. Resting on the rocks is where we find Miss Texas, Michelle Royer. And rising majestically as the mountains is Miss Arizona, Diane Martin. Georgia O'Keeffe's Desert Abstraction is our entrance to the City of the Rocks, where each contestant has staked a claim. Call this Fox on the Rocks because Miss New Jersey is Stacy Joy Fox. Leaning in the sun, we find Miss Nebraska, Amy Wynn Anderson. Two ladies on the lookout remove their sunglasses and they're Patty Thorpe, Miss Utah, and Paula Morrison, Miss West Virginia. From New England to New Mexico comes Rosanna Iverson, Miss Massachusetts. Two states that are football rivals are pageant pals. Diane Rohde is Miss Oklahoma, and Miss Kansas is Martina Castle. From Dairyland to the City of Rocks comes Miss Wisconsin, Regina Maria Park. Miss Washington is Jennifer Dorflinger. Letting the sun shine through her hair is Miss Georgia Sophia Bowen. And before we move on, we meet Miss Iowa, Katie Lynn McGee. Dinosaur Ridge in Spring Canyon Park looks down on two lovely ladies, Miss District of Columbia, Edwina Richard, and Miss Wyoming, Michelle Renee Zimmerman. A lasso and a saddle lead us to Miss North Dakota, Shelley Gangness. While a conch belt shows us the way to Miss Rhode Island, Lisa Benson. Outside the park, we find Miss Virginia, Marcia Rawls, as well as a sunbathing nutmegger and volunteer. Miss Connecticut is Jolene Foy, and Molly Brown is Miss Tennessee. Here with another big wheel is Miss Minnesota, Christine Rosenberger. Now we move inside Spring Canyon Park and find Miss Louisiana, Carol Carter. And a top gun from the Northeast, Carol Woodworth, Miss Vermont. A sure bet to add to the beauty of any setting is Miss Nevada, Tammy Lee Perkins. Two heartbreakers, Beth Woodward, Miss South Carolina, and Miss Ohio, Callie Bonnell, perch appropriately under Lover's Leap. With a cowboy standing watch. Georgia O'Keeffe's art comes to life at White Sands, where a pink rose is held by a bluegrass lady. Miss Kentucky is Beth Ann Clark. A breeze blows the shawl and hair of Vicki Hoffman, Miss Idaho. A sunset is the backdrop for Miss South Dakota, Jana Van Woodenberg. Miss Indiana is Alicia Ray, and Miss Montana is Connie Cola. White Sands look like the snows of home to Miss Alaska, Shelley Dunleavy. Sharing a blanket and some sunshine are Miss Colorado, Holly Kuska, and Miss New Hampshire, Lori Durkee. These lucky dogs walk across the sands with the home state's Kristen Kilgore, Miss New Mexico. A backward glance and a turnaround shows us Miss Maryland, Michelle Snow. And riding like the queen she is, here's Miss Teen USA, Allison Brown. In the custom of the Indians, whose traditions are such a part of this land, our contestants form a circle, reflect on their memories of the land of enchantment, and wave hello from the Miss USA pageant.
Before one of those
last contestants you just saw becomes the new Miss USA, she'll have to become one of our 10 semifinalists. Each of those semifinalists will be judged in three competitive areas tonight: interviews, swimsuits, and evening gowns. Our distinguished panel of celebrity judges will decide on a score for each contestant in each category. Now, those scores, ranging from 1 to 9.99, are entered into terminals just like this one, and then that score goes into our computer. And what happens next is just for us. Those scores will be shown to you, our television audience, but will not be seen by those here in the Coliseum. The computer will average the scores for the three competitions, and the contestants with the five highest scores will be our finalists. And from those five will come our new Miss USA. We'll have to wait for those competitions to learn who our finalists will be, and Bob will have the names of our semifinalists right after this.
Let's stop for a moment and go back in time long enough to see a stepping stone on the way to having a dream come true. It's 1986, and I'm announcing the names of the 10 semifinalists. Look out, folks. Here comes Miss Texas. Now, tonight, another young lady is about to take that step toward her dream, and here's how that happens. Our celebrity panel of judges has a responsibility that actually began a week ago here in Albuquerque. They have already chosen our 10 semifinalists. Each contestant was judged wearing an evening gown of her choice. The preliminary swimsuit competition was held right here on our stage. And each judge personally interviewed every contestant. Now, the results of those judgings were tabulated into our computer, and the contestants with the 10 highest average scores will become our 10 semifinalists. Now, as I pick up the computer printout of those results, please welcome back our 52 contestants in their lovely outfits from the JCPenney Company Miss USA collection.
Names in no particular order, and you at home will see the average score each contestant got for our three areas of preliminary judging, and it looks like Bob is ready.
I am indeed. I have our list of semifinalists, one of whom will become Miss USA 1987. Number one on the list is Miss Arizona. We'll see her score at home, but we do not see it here. And here comes Miss Missouri. Number three on the list is Miss Virginia. And how do you folks feel about Miss New Mexico? Number five, ladies and gentlemen, is Miss Texas. And Miss Florida. A nice welcome now for Miss West Virginia. And how about Miss Nevada? Come on down, Miss Georgia. All right, ladies and gentlemen, have you been counting? What's the next number coming up? 10. You're right. It's Miss Mississippi. Now, no music, please. No music, please. I have a surprise for our contestants. I have a surprise for you judges, too. And as a matter of fact, I have surprises for our cameramen here, because for the first time in pageant history, we've had a tie. We do not have 10 semifinalists. Ladies and gentlemen, we have 11 semifinalists. Now, as you will recall, I am not calling the names in any particular order, alphabetical or otherwise. So the fact that I have one more name does not indicate that this next name is the last in the scoring, because we do not know which girl has which score at this moment. Number 11 is Miss Illinois. Miss Illinois, right here. Would you just move down? You move in. Put her right there in the middle. There you are. Congratulations to our 11 semifinalists, one of whom will be the new Miss USA.
In the Miss USA pageant, our 11 semifinalists have been chosen, and you'll be watching a brand new contest among all of them to become the new Miss USA. In the semifinal competition, our celebrity panel of judges gave the highest score to Miss Texas, with Miss Mississippi second, and Miss Arizona third. But now, all the semifinal scores are set aside. You know, leading up to tonight, our contestants spent a lot of time and effort in rehearsing, but the one thing they didn't get to rehearse is the completely spontaneous interview competition. And that's coming up right after this from Ivory.
The 1987 Miss USA pageant will continue.
Now, I have no idea what's going to happen next, but then neither does anyone else. Oh, I know I'm going to be asking some questions of our 10 semifinalists, make that 11, but 21 years of this has taught me that I don't have the slightest idea what answers I'm going to get. We're going to begin with you, Miss Arizona. Come down to me, please. Miss Arizona is Diane Martin. She's 24. She lives in Phoenix. She's a senior at Arizona State University. And what do you study?
I'm studying theater.
And is it true that you entered the Miss Arizona pageant secretly?
Yes, I did, Bob.
Why did you do that?
Well, I was treating the pageant just like an audition, and if I didn't win, then I would go on with my life, and no one would know, and no one would feel sorry for me if I didn't win, and if I did win, which I did, then I'd be able to call everybody.
You didn't tell your parents?
No, sir.
Do your parents know where you are tonight?
Yes, they do. They're out in the audience right
They're
now.
They're here. Yeah. Now, do you have a boyfriend?
No, I don't.
You do not have a boyfriend?
No, I don't.
Careful. Do you want a boyfriend?
Well, perhaps in the future. Right now, I'm too busy with getting on with my life right now.
I was going to say, any volunteers? This guy means that he has both hands up over here. All right, thank you, Miss Arizona. Miss Missouri, you're next. She is Dawn Fonseca, 22, lives in Independence. She's a professional model. And I read in your bio that someone in your family has a great interest in Barker's Beauties on The Price is Right.
Yes, that's my brother Tobin. Whenever we were little, we used to play The Price is Right. And I was always Janice, and my best friend was Anitra, and he was Bob Barker. And he had the biggest crush on Janice and Anitra, and he's such a nosy little kid that he found their phone numbers, he called them in L.A., and he had a phone bill of about $25, which my parents, of course, caught. And we got in a lot of trouble.
Yes, he found them.
Now,
you know, I'm very strict with those girls. I tell them just what to say. Did they tell your brother what a great guy I am?
Oh, sure, yeah. That's it.
Now, as a professional model, you've traveled all over. I understand you brought a friend back from Spain.
Yes, I did. It's a dog named Romblis. He's better known as Rambo, though, because he's just a little spitfire. He's a real cutie. But over Christmas time, we all go to my parents' house, and everybody brings their dogs, and there's about a pack of 10 there. And it's a madhouse. It's really a lot of fun. But he's a real stingy little dog, and he steals everybody else's bone during Christmas time.
You have 10 dogs, really?
Yes. 10 dogs.
And I have to assume that they're all spayed or neutered.
Oh, of course.
All right. Of course. Thank you, Miss Missouri. Miss Virginia, I'd like to talk with you. She's Marcia Rawls, 24, lives in Alexandria. And she is an art broker. Now, I'm sure that our television audience would like to know, what does an art broker do?
Well, I work for Robert Rauschenberg, who's an American artist, and what I do is people come to me, and if they're interested in buying art, I help put the deal together.
I see. Now, do you do this in Virginia, or do you travel extensively, or what?
I live in Northern Virginia, and I represent him in D.C., and I travel a lot overseas. I spend a lot of time in Europe, and I go to New York as well.
Very good. Now, since you're a traveler, how many pieces of luggage did you bring to the pageant?
I brought 7.
What do you think is the average?
The average is probably between 5 and 8. I think everyone brought a lot.
It is eight. What do you think is the largest number of pieces of luggage brought? I thought these were interesting statistics. I was given these statistics. What do you think is the most brought by any contestant?
I'd guess maybe some girl brought 15.
14. You're very good. 14, yes. But the statistic I was most interested in, one girl brought 46 daytime outfits. She can't go out at night. She has no clothes. 46 daytime outfits. Thank you, Miss Virginia.
Thank you.
And you're next, Miss New Mexico. She is Kristen Kilgore. She's 19. She lives right here in Albuquerque. She's a freshman at the University of New Mexico, and I know you've been talking about this wonderful state for weeks, haven't you?
Absolutely.
I'm going to give you your chance now to tell this CBS audience the glories of New Mexico. What do you want them to know?
Well, first of all, here in New Mexico, the ancient Indian culture plays a very big part on the American people. And when you come into Albuquerque, first of all, you'll see our turquoise and adobe airport. That's only the beginning of the culture here. We also have the three cultures, the Indian, the Spanish, and the Anglo, and we work very hard to work together. And that's only one of the things that makes New Mexico so unique.
Very good. I heard something now that I must mention. Last weekend, the girls were polled as to whom they'd like to spend Valentine's Day with, and some said Tom Cruise, and some said Tom Selleck, and President Reagan, but who did you say?
I said Bob Barker.
And I bring that up so that you will know, no matter what else you know about her, you know she's a young lady of good taste. You say, thank you, Miss New Mexico. Miss Texas. She is Michelle Royer. She's 21. She's from Keller. She attended Tarrant County Junior College. And what did you study in college?
I was studying pre-med. Someday I hope to be a pediatrician.
Very good. Now, I also have been told that you have a 16-year-old brother who is very supportive.
That's right. He's a super guy. His last words to me were, go get him. And I understand that he's wearing his first tuxedo tonight, so I can't wait until the coronation ball so I can see him all dressed up.
Is he here?
He sure is. He's right back there.
I see an awful lot of tuxedos back there. Is it true that you're going to buy him an automobile if you win all this money?
That's right. Half my prize list is promised away if I win the Miss USA crown. I promised my father that he could take part in the car and my mother could have some of the fur, and I'd give my brother $1,000 for to buy a new car.
Did you hear that ripple money through the audience? I ain't gonna say nothing about that right now.
I'm waving back there.
Thank you, Miss Texas. All right, Miss Florida. She is Chloe Cabrera, 22, lives in Tampa. She is a senior at Hillsborough Community College, and what's your major?
Computer data processing.
And what do you hope to do in the future?
Hopefully be a systems analyst.
And you, I understand, have a dear friend named Linda.
Yes, I do. She's home watching now.
And I assume that she'll have a lot to say about this.
I hope so. Uh-huh. My brother promised me he would roll her in front of the TV set so she could watch.
Yes. Maybe we should tell them who Linda is.
Linda is my seven-year-old bilingual parrot.
She has a bilingual parrot because Spanish is your original language.
Yes.
Now, there is a large Spanish-speaking population here in New Mexico. Would you like to say something to them in Spanish?
I sure would.
All right. Here's your chance.
Buenas noches, señores y señores. Señoras y señores, quiero decirle que he pasado un tiempo muy lindo aquí en Bello, México, y que dicho en México, mi casa es su casa. Sí, sinceramente, estoy en mi casa. Gracias.
Thank you, Miss Florida.
Thank you.
Yeah. I would simply like to add, I could not have said it better myself. Now, our armchair judges and our celebrity panel have seen and heard half of our interview competition, and there's another half yet to come.
As I'm sure our reigning Miss USA, Christy Fitchner, will agree, we can't stress too strongly the importance to our judges of what happens on this stage, right, Christy?
That's absolutely true, Mary. A lot of us remember that in 1982, Terry Utley had the next to lowest preliminary score among the semifinalists. But when it was all over, she walked away with that crown.
And that is what counts. So it's not over till it's over. And who knows? Something like that could be happening here again tonight. Bob has five more semifinalists to interview, and he'll be doing that when we come back after this word.
The first half of our interview competition is over, and for those of you who are keeping your own scores, get your pencils ready, because we're going to begin the second half with Miss West Virginia, who is Paula Morrison. She's 22. She lives in Barbersville, and she is a junior at Marshall University. And what is your major?
I majored in marketing, and I hope one day to own a retail stores of my own, a chain of them, beginning in West Virginia, then continuing out through the Carolinas.
A retail chain of your own? Now, how large is Barbersville?
Barbersville's approximately about 4,000.
All right. Based on the studies that you have already had there in school, what sort of store would you like to have? What would be a success in Barbersville?
Well, I would have it in the larger cities in West Virginia, not necessarily Barbersville. I would have it in the mall.
You see, she hasn't even gone into business, and she's moved out of town already. Now, go ahead.
No, I would start it in the various malls in West Virginia, and it depend on who would give me the best opportunity, and then continue that change on through probably the Carolinas, because I've been through and I have visited some of the malls in there, and they have gotten some nice things.
Very good. Now, if you would like to invest in this project, send your money to Bob Barker, B-A-R-K-E-R, right?
Correct.
Thank you, Miss West Virginia. All right, Miss Nevada. She is Tammy Lee Perkins, 21, lives in Las Vegas, attends the University of Nevada at Las Vegas. And what are you studying?
I'm studying to become a child psychologist.
And what are your plans for the future?
Well, my ambitions are to successfully combine career, marriage, and motherhood. Right now, what's very important to me is to major in child psychology.
Now, you would never guess it to look at her, but you are a gold miner, aren't you?
Yes, sir, I am.
And what do you pan for gold?
Yes, I do. Now, I try to get rich.
Well, that's good. Yes, that's very good. We've all heard of panning for gold, but I bet there are not three people in this audience or at home there probably watching who really know. How do you do it?
Well, it's sort of a long story. What you do is you begin early in the morning. You get up with your family or your friends. You go out to a nearby city or desert, whatever, which one you choose. You get your pan, a small shovel. You go and find a river, and you go in the river and you pour water and the dirt, and you swivel that around inside the gold pan, and you're hoping that when you get to the very end that you'll see a very large chunk. Unfortunately, I haven't found a large chunk yet, but I will. I'm determined.
You may find a large chunk tonight, right here.
Hopefully I will.
Thank you, Miss Nevada.
Thank you.
We're ready for you, Miss Georgia. Sophia Bowen, 21. She lives in Marietta. She attended the University of Alabama at Birmingham. And what did you study at the university?
Early childhood education. My plans are to be a school teacher one day.
Why did you choose to become a school teacher?
Well, I love children. And when I was a little girl, I used to play school teacher all the time. And also, there are so many single parents today. And I also want to be a mother figure to children who don't get the love at home.
Now, you have already won the Miss Photogenic title.
Yes, I did.
Which must have been a big thrill. Miss Photogenic is selected by the photographers who are covering the pageant, and that was a thrill.
Yes, I was quite surprised. I had some of the contestants backstage say, "You're going to win Miss Photogenic." I said, "No, no way, because I'm my own worst critic." And what happened? I won Miss Photogenic, so it was quite an honor.
And she's been told by so many people that she looks like Brooke Shields. Brooke Shields was probably flattered that you're Miss Photogenic, too.
I hope so.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And Miss Mississippi, Catherine Manning, 24, lives in Drew, Mississippi. A graduate of the University of Mississippi. And what do you have a degree in?
I have a degree in psychology, Bob.
Have you used any psychology here at the pageant?
A lot. Coping skills.
Coping? What have you been coping with?
Oh, just the everyday stress of getting up at 5:30 in the morning, breakfast at 7, coming to rehearsal all day long, going home for dinner, and then going out to some function that we have to attend here in town.
And it was a lot of fun.
Yes, great fun.
And you would recommend it to any young lady watching?
I certainly would.
And you are very pleased that you came.
Very pleased that I came.
And you didn't want anything you said to, for one moment, to be interpreted as criticism.
Not at all.
You see how well-trained this child really is? Thank you, Miss Mississippi.
Thank you.
All right, Miss Illinois, she is Joan Berg. She's 21. She lives in Arlington Heights. She's a senior at the University of Illinois at Champaign. And what is your major?
I'm majoring in marketing of textiles and apparel.
And what do you want to do eventually?
I would like to own my own marketing consulting firm someday to help the retail industry in this country, because I believe in American-made products, and right now we're having difficulty in the retail industry.
You want to own a retail consulting, marketing consulting?
That's correct.
What is it? What would you do?
Well, hopefully, if a business was having problems, they would come to Joan Berg's retail consulting firm. And I would try to find where they're having problems, if it's the market niche or their product or where they're located in a particular community.
You'd solve problems.
That's right.
Are you a Chicago Bears fan?
You bet I am.
What would you do? What would you do to solve the problems with the Chicago Bears? The coach is having a problem with the owner. He's having a problem with his star quarterback. They have a quarterback who may be too small for the NFL. What would you do about all this?
Well, maybe if the team let me try to consult them on winning, I don't know.
I think the Bears would like that, yes. Thank you, Miss Illinois.
Thank you.
Our first semifinal competition of the evening has been completed. Ahead, we have two more, as well as some fine entertainment. But right now, a recap from Mary.
Here's another look at our judges' selections as the three highest scores in our interview competition. They gave the highest score to Miss Florida, with Miss Texas second, and Miss Mississippi third. There's more competition ahead, as well as some great entertainment. And we'll be meeting the people who will choose the new Miss USA and seeing what she's going to win right after this word from ERA.
Our 36th Miss USA will be crowned here tonight. We'll win a prize package totaling more than $200,000 in cash and merchandise. That includes a $25,000 personal appearance contract, a $15,000 first prize award, the opportunity to represent our country in the Miss Universe pageant, which will come to you live on CBS from exotic and exciting Singapore on May 26th, as well as all these prizes Mary is going to tell us about.
Miss USA will fly first class to any eastern destination of her choice. Whether it's to the beautiful beaches of Florida, an enchanting Caribbean island, or the splendor of South America, she'll fly with Eastern. For Miss USA and everyone else, Eastern is the one to the sun. From DV Hotels, 40 weeks ownership in a Caribbean condo with membership in the Interval International Exchange Program. In addition to a $10,000 cash prize, the new Miss USA will receive a complete traveling wardrobe, sportswear, dresses, and suits from JCPenney, the exclusive retailer of Miss USA apparel. Along with a $5,000 cash award, she'll receive the fabulous feeling of ivory hair with a 5-year supply of ivory shampoo and conditioner. Ivory, the official hair care system for the Miss USA pageant. For those moments that are important, our new Miss USA will receive, in addition to a $10,000 cash award, a 5-year supply of cosmetics from Maybelline, the official cosmetic for the Miss USA pageant. In addition to a $5,000 cash award, Miss USA will win a year's wardrobe from Kinney, the great American shoe store. Once again, the official footwear of the Miss USA pageant, Kinney has a style for every occasion. Miss USA will receive a cash award of $6,000, video products, and the revolutionary Maxim SLR autofocus system from Minolta, the world's most complete autofocusing system only from the mind of Minolta. And from Paramount, their top 100 movies on video cassette. In addition to a $5,000 wardrobe by Mary McFadden, our winner will receive a $5,000 cash award, both from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the Miss USA pageant. Miss USA will tan richly with her new Sun Swivel 700S from Rothschild Sun Systems. Rothschild brings in the sunshine, rain or shine. To top off her wardrobe, our winner will receive this magnificent natural black llama mink coat, awarded by the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company in Flemington, New Jersey. From Gordon's Jewelers, Miss USA will receive a beautiful collection of jewelry designed in her honor. Rings, pendants, and earrings set with diamonds and gemstones at Gordon's Jewelers. More than 400 stores coast to coast. Miss USA will soon drive away in her new Mazda RX-7 sports car, powered by a fuel-injected rotary engine. Her Mazda features a special luxury package including sunroof, six-way seat, and 100-watt stereo system. All this for the new Miss USA.
Now that we've seen all the lovely prizes our new Miss USA will receive, it's time for Bob to introduce us to the people who'll decide who that lucky lady will be. Bob?
Thank you, Mary. Whoever tonight's winner is, the choice will be made by a dedicated panel of celebrity judges who have spent the entire week diligently preparing themselves for that big decision, and I would like to introduce them right now. First, the energetic flight attendant on the hit comedy series Perfect Strangers, Rebecca Arthur. From nearby Santa Fe, one of America's most renowned impressionist landscape painters, Doug Higgins. Dancer and choreographer, best known to television audiences for her work on the annual CBS special Circus of the Stars, Betty Hyatt Aidman. The unique costume designer whose creations are favorites of both men and women celebrities, Rhett Turner. One of America's favorite daytime drama stars, she is Iva Snyder on As the World Turns, Lisa Brown. One of Hollywood's leading casting directors, whose assignments currently include The Colbys and Dynasty, Mark Schwartz. A Broadway and television actress and singer, as well as a recording artist, currently starring in the comedy series The New Gidget, Karen Richman. Rated by many as the country's number one celebrity photographer with over 1,000 major magazine covers, Dick Zimmerman. Having starred in both daytime drama and on Broadway, she is now starring on The Colbys as Channing Carter Colby, Kim Morgan Green. Los Angeles Herald Examiner fashion editor and nationally syndicated columnist Gwen Jones. Outstanding comedian and master impressionist, he stars April 12th in his own television special, appropriately called The Many Faces of Fred Travellina. That's our celebrity panel of judges, and on behalf of everyone associated with tonight's pageant, thank you all.
Well, I'm backstage in the dressing room where, understandably, there is an enormous amount of excitement and where our 10 semifinalists are getting ready for the swimsuit competition, which is coming up next. Now, while you folks were meeting our judges, I was back here learning about some of the good luck charms that these young ladies brought with them to the pageant. And I want you to learn what I learned. Now, what is the good luck charm you told me you brought with you?
Oh, I brought a pin that was given to me from Lori Lewis, who was Miss West Virginia 2 years ago.
So you're just holding on to that, hoping it'll bring you the same good fortune.
I'll wear it everywhere I go.
Good luck. How about you? Missouri.
Actually, my dad has my good luck charm, and it's at home, and it's a bottle of Dom Perignon on ice. So hopefully we'll be celebrating with it earlier.
You become Miss USA, you'll be opening that tonight. What about you, Miss Ford?
Hi, I have a wishbone from a piece. I have a wishbone from a chicken that I ate right before coming to Albuquerque.
That's the most unusual good luck charm I've
ever heard now.
Good luck digesting it. And what about you, Miss Tex?
Well, a couple of months ago, my father stopped and picked up a hat in the road, and he couldn't figure out why. And when he turned it around, it said USA on it, so I brought it with me.
So that should bode well for you. Well, I just want to say that I wish all of you good luck tonight. Our contestants meet their next challenge in the swimsuit competition, and that happens right after this.
Resume our judgment as our 11 semifinalists wearing their exclusive Miss USA competition swimsuits by JCPenney Company rejoin us for the swimsuit competition. The setting is an unusual one for our competition, but certainly appropriate for this area, which includes the plains, the desert, and the New Mexico mountains, complete with snow and a ski lodge. Now the 1987 Miss USA swimsuit competition. First, here is Miss Arizona. Miss Arizona and all of the ladies are wearing simulated furs.
Diane
is 24 years old and stands 5 feet 8 inches tall. She has green eyes and black hair. She weighs 120 pounds.
Miss Missouri!
Dawn has brown eyes and light brown hair. She weighs 120 pounds and is 5 feet 9 inches tall.
Miss Virginia!
Marcia has green eyes and blonde hair. She is 24 years old. Marcia is 5 feet 7 inches tall and weighs 114 pounds.
Miss New Mexico!
Is 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighs 118 pounds. She has gray eyes and golden brown hair. Kristen is 19 years old.
Miss Texas.
Michelle has blue eyes and brown hair. She is 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighs 129 pounds. Michelle is 21 years old.
Miss Florida!
Is 22 years old. She has brown eyes and dark brown hair. She weighs 139 pounds and stands 5 feet 11 inches tall.
Miss West Virginia.
Has brown hair and brown eyes. She is 5 feet 8 inches tall and weighs 118 pounds.
Miss Nevada.
Tammy Lee has brown eyes and brown hair. She is 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighs 127 pounds.
Miss Georgia.
Sophia stands 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighs 130 pounds. She is 21 years old.
Miss Mississippi.
Kelly stands 5 feet 7½ inches tall and weighs 115 pounds. Kathy is 24 years old.
Miss Illinois.
Joan is 21 years old. She has honey blonde hair and green eyes. Joan weighs 112 pounds and is 5 feet 7 inches tall.
Two competitions down, one to go. Still going with your original selection, or are you waiting until after the evening gown competition?
Our judges scored the swimsuit competition. They gave the highest score to Miss Texas, with Miss Missouri second, and Miss Arizona third. Now, just ahead, a salute to the West and its cowboys with our contestants and TV's legendary rifleman, Chuck Connors, when we come back after this word from Folgers. Rehearsal that you heard about is ready to pay off, because as you can see by their costumes, they're going to do something Western. And here's Bob to tell us about it.
Over the years, the cities and towns of New Mexico were home for some of the men who were the legends of the West, men like Johnny Ringo and Billy the Kid. There was also the fictional town of North Fork, New Mexico, where television audiences tuned in to see a man named Lucas McCain, the rifleman, played by Chuck Connors.
You know, the West is a state of mind, a state where everybody lives. I call it the eternal frontier, where there's always a beautiful sunset to ride off into and a glorious sunrise to wake up to. The pioneers who made New Mexico happen were not afraid to build, to battle, and to bleed, because they had a dream for themselves and for all of us. Their spirit is still remembered, not only in New Mexico, but all over America. And some say their spirits still ride the mountains, silhouetted against the sky.
Thank you. Congratulations, ladies, you were great. What a spectacular number. I don't think there's a town in all of the United States you couldn't take over and look great doing it. Bravo. You know, rehearsals for things like you just saw and fittings, photo sessions, interviews, all these and more have kept our contestants on the go while they've been here. But being firm believers that all work and no play has the same effect on Jill that it does on Jack, they made time for some fun, too. Just as there's an old saying about when in Rome, our young ladies joined right into the spirit of Albuquerque, home of the world's largest hot air balloon fiesta. They learned about all the things necessary to do on the ground before an ascent. And finally, it was up, up, and away in what was a brand new and exciting experience for most of them. What wasn't so new, but was fun, was proving to their friends that they were good skates. Our ladies move in classy circles and might run into anyone, including themselves. They're wearing the latest in fashion sportswear from the JCPenney Company. Shopping was certainly part of the reasons our ladies look forward to visiting Santa Fe. Eye-catching turquoise and silver and chili peppers. Renowned as a cultural center, Santa Fe's art galleries were also attractions to our contestants. Since workouts are often a big part of their lifestyles at home, the young ladies didn't want to neglect their conditioning while they were in Albuquerque. Our contestants want to stop moving? Why Stan Place? When he conducts the annual makeup clinic on behalf of Maybelline, the official cosmetic of the Miss USA pageant. Even when he gives them special attention, he might also be giving them the brush. The contestants were anxious to try out the different opportunities offered by the snow in New Mexico. There were snowmobiles. There was plenty of skiing, complete with slopes and chairlifts and cheering. And even the well-known agony of defeat. Except in this case, the agony gave way to fun. And there was tubing, made up of equal parts snow, contestants, and inner tubes, followed, of course, by an opera tube party around a roaring fire, which involved refreshments, talking, and laughing until the sun went down. Then what? Well, what else? More dancing, of course. It's great to be young, lovely, and a Miss USA contestant who knows how to relax after a long day of dance rehearsals. Even when they're beat, the beat goes on, and it's fun. Having had a chance to watch our contestants enjoying their leisure time, we return for more of our competition, and that would be our evening gown segment coming up right after this.
The background is a grand adobe New Mexico hacienda, where our young ladies have been invited to a military ball given by the members of the Kirtland Air Force Base Sabre Drill Team. They're escorted by officers of the Naval Air Training Command Choir, and it all comes together to represent a lovely, formal Southwestern evening. It also is the background for our third semifinal competition, with each contestant in a gown of her own choosing.
Love lift us up where we belong.
Miss USA Evening Gown Competition. We begin with Miss Arizona.
Take my breath away.
Missouri.
There's so many ways I want to say I love you. Let me hold you in my arms, oh, evermore. In my eyes, I see no one else but you. There's no other love like our love. And yes,
Miss Virginia. Mexico. Texas. Miss West Virginia.
I just gotta tell the world about you. Let's hear it for the girl who made one man's dream come true. Let's hear it for
Nevada.
Peace to the rest of forever. You're my lady.
Georgia. Mississippi.
Far from the world we know, but where the feelings go. Lady, my special lady, oh, my lady. Well, lift us up where we belong, where the eagles fly.
Miss Illinois.
The conclusion of our evening gown competition means that shortly our 11 semifinalists will turn into 5 finalists. The question, of course, is which 5?
Our semifinal competitions are over. And in the evening gown judging, our panel gave the highest score to... Texas. With Miss Arizona second. And Miss Missouri third. You know, to make a show like ours happen requires the cooperation, the encouragement, and the hospitality of our hosts. And here we have been most fortunate in all those areas. And we would like to acknowledge our debt to some of the people here in our audience right now. The Honorable Gary Carruthers, Governor of the State of New Mexico. The Honorable Ken Schultz, Mayor of the City of Albuquerque. And W. Gary Grimmer, Executive Director, Albuquerque Convention and Visitors Bureau. Our thanks to you and to all who work so hard with you. And Bob will be announcing the names of our 5 finalists when we come back after this word from Prell.
The 1987 Miss USA pageant will continue.
Everything that our celebrity panel of judges has seen and heard tonight has also been seen and heard by you. Now it's time for you to match your opinions with their decisions. Only our television audience will see the average score each finalist receives for the 3 semifinal competitions. Everyone here can feel the excitement, and I sense that our contestants and our audience don't really want to hear anything more from me except the name of our 5 finalists, and I have those computer results right here, do I not? Thank you. Now, good luck to all of you. Here are the names of the 5 finalists. The first is Miss Texas. And how do you feel about Miss Georgia? You have seemed to like Miss Florida. Another of your favorites was Miss Missouri. And now, number 5 on the list, and ladies and gentlemen, there are only 5. Number 5 is Miss Arizona. And there they are, the 5 finalists for the title of Miss USA 1987.
Have been chosen, and I'm sure you can hear the enormous amount of excitement and tension here tonight. For the 3 areas of our semifinal competitions, the judges gave the highest average score to Miss Texas, with Miss Florida second, and Miss Missouri third. One of our 5 finalists is always going to remember New Mexico as the place where she won her crown. But all 52 of our contestants will keep wonderful memories of a unique experience in a very unique place, which is currently enjoying its Diamond Jubilee celebration. Congratulations, New Mexico. Yes, we're happy to be a part of it. And we couldn't ask for a lovelier guide to show us this area than the reigning Miss USA, Christy Bichner.
Track in New Mexico.
Idaho State Fairgrounds are right next to the Tingley Coliseum, where tonight's telecast is originating. So excitement, dancing, fancy plumage, and colorful lights are nothing new to the area. It's where the tourist, the cowboy, the artisan, the musician, the craftsman, the farmer all come to be a part of the tradition and the excitement of the West. But reflection in New Mexico does not merely mean looking back at the wonderful yesterdays, because as you look around the land of enchantment, something becomes apparent very quickly.
There's a high-tech side to life here as well. The abundant new Mexican sunshine helps provide a glimpse into the future. At Kirtland Air Force Base, the Department of Energy is conducting a series of solar experiments that will power us into the next century.
That same sun shines on the combination of tradition and progress that is the growing city of Albuquerque. A city on the move. On a clear day, you can see forever. The world's longest continuous aerial tramway takes you to the top of Sandia Peak on a breathtaking 15-minute ride. Unlike other rides, on this one it's the beauty you behold that takes your breath away. Just as adobe architecture says New Mexico to the traveler, so does its legendary art. The magnificence of the great Santa Fe and Taos masters, as well as the New Mexican mystique of George O'Keefe, are found here. The magic of Hollywood keeps the spirit of the Old West alive in New Mexico. At the Eves Movie Ranch, things are not always as they seem. Just another day in the land of enchantment. The presence of nature's majesty is reflected in everything you see, whether it's a vast scope of countryside or a sparkling little twig.
The rugged beauty of New Mexico is also found in these majestic canyons of the Bandelier National Monument. The 15-mile crater of the Jemez volcano is one of the world's largest.
The natural beauty and breathtaking colors of New Mexico have always attracted artists wanting to capture the beauty of the master painter who created the land of enchantment.
Ahead, we have some surprises for our finalists, and our judges will make their final selections. Both of those will be coming up right after this word from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1987 Miss USA pageant.
We decided to try something new this year. We arranged to get several snapshots of each of our contestants. We've picked out some. They don't know which ones. And we're going to ask our finalists about them. Unlike our computer scores, these pictures will be seen by our audience here, too. And we're going to begin with Miss Texas. Come right down here with me, will you please, Miss Texas? Down here on this monitor, you'll be able to see three pictures with me, and we'll pick out one to talk with about. Oh, it has to be number one. Look at that. Yes. Let's have a little talk about number one. At what age was that taken?
Well, that looks like it was about two, and since I was sleeping, I don't really remember that. But I will say that I still sleep that way today.
I think that's a great picture. Thank you, Miss Texas. Yes. Miss Georgia, come down here to me. And we have pictures of you, too, Miss Georgia. Let's see. Oh, look at number one. Two, in two of them, you're eating, it looks as if you are, anyway. Let's talk about number one with her, too. Now, I don't suppose you remember this incident. Do you have any idea how old you were?
I would say I was probably about 3 months old.
And you're not eating, you're talking on a phone, aren't you?
Yes, I'm talking on the phone, and I still talk on the phone today.
A lot.
A lot, yes.
Thank you, Miss Georgia.
Thank you.
All right, Miss Florida. Now, I do believe that the folks in New Mexico like you. Let's see here now. Do you see something there you'd like to talk about?
Number three.
All right, number three. That's the one we'll talk about. I can't see them too well down there on that monitor. You're going to have to help me now. I assume that that is a picture of you, and who else is there?
I'm riding a chicken.
Oh, it's a chicken. I thought it was your boyfriend there for a minute with you. It is a huge chicken.
Where did you find
that chicken?
That was at Laurie Park in Tampa. My mom thought I was too small to ride the horse, so she put me on the chicken instead.
What were you then?
Happy.
you're about what, 18, 17 years old?
About eight, seven or eight.
All right, thank you, Miss Florida. Okay. Miss Missouri? We want to see some pictures of Miss Missouri. And we have pictures of Miss Missouri. Now, number one is a baby picture. Number two, I can't tell what that is. I think our audience... Oh, I think I do see what that is. Can we take a closer look at that on television? If it's there, I'm not... You are on what I think you are on.
Yes, I'm sitting on the toilet. I must have been about 4 years old.
And you sent these to us, so if we've shown it, it's not our fault.
My mom made me send that.
I'll bet your mother thinks that's the cutest picture of you, doesn't she?
I'll never forgive her.
Oh, it's cute. Thank you, Miss Missouri. Miss Arizona, here we go. Yes, nice welcome for you, too. Now we have pictures down here, and I believe that is an animal over there in number three. It looks like a tricycle in number... Well, there. Let's talk about number two now. That is an interesting-looking feller there in overalls. Who is he?
I want you to know that picture number two is the one and only dance that I went to in high school. And
the
it was
only
a girl.
Dance?
Yes, it was a girl-ass-guy dance, Sadie Hawkins.
Why didn't you go to any dances with guys?
Nobody
asked
me.
I asked you during the interview if you wanted me to help you find a boyfriend. You said later in life.
Oh, I was hoping it would be you.
You're good. Oh. This man. I'll tell you one thing. It's lucky for the rest of you I don't have a vote after that line. Thank you, Miss Arizona. And I want to thank all of you ladies. Thank you very much. It's time now to move on to our moment of decision for our judges and, of course, for you folks at home.
Now all our scores are wiped away as our judges choose from among our final five, and this is the deciding vote. As each finalist comes center stage, the judges will enter into the computer not a score, but rather a choice of whether that contestant should be our fourth, third, second, or first runner-up, or whether she should be our new Miss USA.
All right, we begin with Miss Texas. Right now, our judges are telling our computer whether Miss Texas is their choice as fourth, third, second, or first runner-up, or Miss USA. And Miss Georgia. Everyone feels the tension right now, but nobody feels it more than Miss Georgia as our judges cast their final vote. Miss Florida. For one of these five young ladies, her life is changing, and Miss Florida wonders if it's changing for her while our judges are voting. Miss Missouri. Remember, the judges are voting on placements for each of our finalists, not giving them scores. Right now, they are giving their placement to Miss Missouri. And Miss Arizona. Have our judges chosen the new Miss USA, or are they doing it right now? That's what Miss Arizona and the rest of us will be finding out soon. And now our judging is over. Our computer has the name of the winner.
One of her benefits will be the chance to represent her country in the Miss Universe pageant, which you will see here on CBS on May 26th, live from the exciting city of Singapore. With me is the reigning Miss Universe, Barbara Palacios Tede from Venezuela. And you have been to Singapore, right?
Yes, Mary, and what a city it is.
Now, it will be a thrill for all of us to bring the Orient live into living rooms all over the world. When you hear people describe Singapore, you usually hear the word exotic, don't you, Barbara?
That's the right word, but there's also beautiful and mysterious.
And they say that Singapore is yesterday, today, and tomorrow, and that it has the one thing that is most important to any traveler, and Barbara and I definitely agree on what that is, don't we, Barbara?
We sure do.
Food, yeah. Singapore is in the future, but in the present is the announcement of who will be the new Miss USA. And that's coming up right after this word from Chloraseptic.
It's time now for our reigning Miss USA, Christy Pitchner, to take her traditional walk and deliver her words of farewell and accept our congratulations on a job well done. Here is Miss USA, Christy Pitchner.
My year as Miss USA has given me a greater appreciation of this country. The knowledge that people from diversified backgrounds unite to form this country increases my appreciation. To those whom I've met, I say thank you. To the pageant staff, I'll miss you. And to my family, I give all my love. Miss USA 1987, you have a challenging year ahead of you. Always remember, you are representative of the greatest country in the world.
Thank you, Christy. Our computer has tabulated the votes of our judges, printed the result, and that printout will list the names of our fourth, third, second, and first runners-up, as well as the new Miss USA. These results have been reviewed by representatives of the international accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney, and they will be given to me right now by Mr. Mark Ward of that firm. Thank you, Mark. Now, before I read this, I'd like to take just a moment to address all of the young ladies who have taken part in tonight's pageant. It is usual to say you are all winners, and you are, just by having taken part tonight. But also, this pageant has been a winner because you have participated in it. To all of you, on behalf of everyone associated with this pageant, a very sincere thank you. Now, to our five finalists, I say good luck. And be assured that we would be happy and proud to have any one of you reign as the new Miss USA. And joining us for this thrilling moment are two ladies who know just how exciting it can be. Laura Martinez Herring, Miss USA 1985, and our reigning Miss Universe, Barbara Palacios Tede. All right, here we go. I shall read the name of the fourth runner-up first. The fourth runner-up is Miss Georgia. You did very well. The third runner-up is Miss Missouri. The Shoshone State will be proud of you. The second runner-up is Miss Arizona. Now, Miss Florida and Miss Texas, will you come down here to me, please? One of you is about to become Miss USA. The other will be the first runner-up, which is a very important position, because if for any reason Miss USA cannot fulfill her obligation for the entire year, the first runner-up becomes Miss USA. Now, I'm going to read the name of the first runner-up, and then I'll read the name of Miss USA. The first runner-up
is Miss Florida. Miss Texas is Miss USA. Congratulations, Michelle Royer. Three winners in a row from Texas. You're the new Miss USA. The cash awards and all the magnificent prizes are hers, and also the chance to be our country's representative in Singapore for the Miss Universe pageant on May 26th. Now, as your predecessor, Christy Fitchner, reads the Miss USA creed, why don't you walk right out there and show everyone how happy you are to be the new Miss USA.
Representing the states of the United States in the Miss USA pageant, in order to further the cause of peace, justice, and mutual understanding, we solemnly dedicate ourselves to the highest ideals of sportsmanship, friendship, and goodwill among all of the people of the United States.
Now, on behalf of Michelle Royer, our third winner in a row from the state of Texas, and myself, this is Bob Barker saying good night, everyone.
EastEast is pleased to have been selected to assist with air transportation from throughout the United States for tonight's special telecast. Eastern, the one to the sun.
The Cinderella slipper was found to fit Miss Texas, Michelle Royer, and she became Miss USA 1987. For her, for Bob Barker, our guests, our contestants, and everyone connected with tonight's pageant, we'll be looking for you on May 26th when we bring you the Miss Universe pageant live from Singapore, right here on CBS. I'm Mary Fran. Good night, everyone.
Hey, South Florida, do you have what it takes to guess that game-winning answer? Then you, too, can unlock the secret to the $100,000 pyramid weeknights at 7:30 on Channel 4.